Hello everyone, myself is Dr. Ravi Kumar, Assistant Professor Tech 3 in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Engineering College, Bikaner. Today I continue my last topic, that is selection of refrigerants. In the last lecture, we have discussed about the properties in which we have already discussed the thermodynamic and thermophysical properties. Today we have discussed the second one, that is environmental and safety properties, and the third one, economics. So the environmental and safety properties, it is observed that finally whether the refrigerant can be used or not is decided only by the thermodynamic or thermophysical properties, but mainly by the environmental and safety issues. This is the reason why refrigerants such as a carbon dioxide and ammonia and sulfur dioxide, which give a high performance, but they are phased out due to safety reasons. Most of them are used to create a safety related problems such as a toxicity. That is the reason we were phased out some of the refrigerants, and we are going to the synthetic refrigerants which were invented. So safety related properties are very important, and now let us look what is the environmental and safety properties. And the properties are, that is, first is ozone depletion potentials. The ODP should be zero. That means the ozone depletion potential of the refrigerant should be zero. And the ODP of the refrigerant or fluid depends mainly upon the number of fluorine or bromine atoms in the molecules. If the molecules contains chlorine or bromine atoms, then it will have non-zero ODP value. As per its mandatory protocol, and we have discussed in some points in history, the protocol cannot be used any refrigerant which has non-zero ODP value. That is the protocol, and that means all ozone depletion substances have been phased out or has to be phased out. So in future the refrigerant should be of non-ODS. Non-ODS means non-ozone depletion substances. Then second is global warming potential, that is GWP, global warming potentials. It should be as small as possible. That means the refrigerants having high global warming potentials are not recommended. In fact, the photo protocol or the mandatory protocols. And under the protocols, the several refrigerants which have a high global warming potentials value have come under these substances, that is ODS, non-ozone depletion substances, to be regulated. Because high global warming potential means you have been greenhouse effects. So the global warming is an environmental issue of global scale. So it is not recommended to use refrigerants having a high global warming potentials value. Then the next is total equivalent warming index. This index takes into account the direct as well as indirect contribution of refrigerants to global warming. The total equivalent warming index should be as small as possible for refrigerants. So the global warming potential, as we discussed, it is directly and indirectly depend upon the refrigerants. As the direct contribution of refrigerant to global warming, that are directly contribution of the that are directly contribution, then the refrigerants leaks into the atmosphere. This means when you release a refrigerant to atmosphere, what are its contribution to global warming? This is considered while estimating the global warming potential. And second is indirect contribution. In case of indirect contributions, global warming, the indirect contribution is depending upon the energy consumptions. For example, if a refrigerant of a system which using a particular refrigerant consuming a higher amount of energy compared to the another refrigerant, then this particular refrigerant contributes to global warming indirectly because higher energy consumption means higher burning of coals and etc. So this is indirectly contribution of the refrigerants. So these direct as well as indirect contribution of refrigerants has been taken into a single index, that is known as or called as a total equivalent warming index. Next is toxicity. Toxicity, obviously the refrigerant should be non-toxic. This means this is related to the hazards or hazardous nature of the refrigerant. As far as human beings are concerned, the refrigerant is toxic, then if the person is exposed to such refrigerant, he will be suffocated. Or obviously the refrigerant should not be toxic. So as I said, the toxicity is a relative term which becomes meaningful only when the degree of concentration and the time of exposure required to produce harmful effects are specified. The refrigerants such as R12 and R22 are non-toxic in the presence of air. But when these refrigerants like R12 are used in open flame, they decompose in the presence of open flame and air. It releases a very dangerous gases like phosgene. So ultimately the toxicity depends upon many other issues, that concentration and the time of exposure and conditions, etc. So the next properties for the environmental and safety: flammability. Obviously the refrigerant should be non-flammable and non-explosive, which have certain points. Non-flammable refrigerants, special precautions should be taken to avoid the accidents. ASHRAE, that is American Society for Heating Refrigerants and Air Conditioning Engineers, has divided the refrigerants into 6 safety groups, and these safety groups are A1, A2, A3 and B1, B2, B3. The refrigerants belonging to the group A1, that is R1, R12, R22, etc., are least hazards, while the refrigerants belonging to the group B3, for example R1140, are the most hazardous refrigerants. The next property is called the chemical stability. As far as possible, the refrigerant should be chemically stable as long as it is within the system. For example, in the compressor, that means it should be chemically stable for a long time. Then compatibility with the common material of construction. The common material of construction are both metallic metals as well as non-metals. Before we go to the next point, we have discussed a little about the material and the construction. This is a very important practical requirement for the refrigerant, that we use should be compatible with the all material of construction, such as a material used for constructing of heat exchangers, the various shield used in the systems and the various plastic used in the system. So it should be non-react with the any other materials. So the compatibility with the material of the refrigerant, it is important. The next point, that is miscibility with the lubricating oils. The miscibility with lubricating oil is a very complex issue, because it is not necessary that the refrigerant should be completely miscible with the lubricating oil. So it has a certain point. The first point, if a refrigerant is not at all miscible with a lubricating oil. In first point, for example, ammonia. Ammonia is not all miscible with lubricating oil. Then what we have to do? We have install an oil separator at the exit of the compressor, so that you can collect oil from the refrigerant vapors and send it back to the compressor, so that the oil does not circulate through the system. That is come under the first point, when refrigerant is not at miscible. The second point is completely miscible. When the refrigerant are completely miscible with oil lubricants, for example R12, hot valve which is completely miscible in the refrigerant, then completely miscible refrigerant in, and also it has a no problem, because since it is no problem, because since it is miscible oil, is miscible with the refrigerant oil, will circulate along with the refrigerant. Means, because since it is miscible oil, is miscible with the refrigerant oil, will circulate along with the refrigerants. And you take care of the design of the evaporators tubes, then the oil will comes back to the compressor. So in this principle, there is a no problem with the refrigerants which are completely miscible and which are not completely miscible. When the problem is comes with the partially miscible refrigerants. So in partially miscible refrigerants, that's the last point, sorry sir. The problem comes with refrigerants which is partially miscible. This is the last point of the previous slides I have discussed here. So in partially miscible refrigerants such as R22, you have to take extra care to make sure that the lubricating oil is coming back to the compressor. So you must know the relationship between the lubricating oil and the refrigerants. So this has the bearing on the design of the system. And then the next point for the environmental safety issue is dielectric strength. The dielectric strength is a very important in system using hermetic compressors. We know that in hermetic compressors, the refrigerants come in contact with the electric winding of the motors. So the dielectric strength of the refrigerant should be high, so that it will not break down. That is not very important when you talking about open type of compressor. So dielectric strength is not very important in case of open compressors. Then next point is ease of leak detection. If the refrigerant leaks out of the system, you should be able to detect it immediately. So in this case, if you are not able to detect the leak of the refrigerant, then you do not know the refrigerant is leaking of the system. What happens if it is a refrigerant is leaking out of the system, and if you are not able to detect it first, so what is the effect? First is the performance of the refrigeration system is affected, and secondly, due to the leakage problem, suffocation is, and maybe third problem is during leak, third problem is that you cannot take, if you know there is a leakage immediately, you take some prevention, some measures. So there are some various methods. So there are various methods for detecting the leakage of the refrigerants. For example, if you use ammonia, in ammonia you do not need anything, because your nose itself is the best leakage detector during ammonia. Okay, ammonia has a very strong odor smell, so immediately you know that it is leaked out. But on the other hand, if you use another refrigerant just like R12 R134, so you need some leak detectors, like a detector, electronics detectors, etc. So this is again an important practical requirements in case of leaking of the refrigerants. Then the third property is based upon the economics. That is, important economics properties are, first is the refrigerant cost. So it should be as cheap as possible, so that your initial cost will be low and it should be easily available. The availability, it is the source material, it should be easily available. So it is also an important practical issues for the refrigerant selections. Because if you select any refrigerant which is not available, then you will not be able to design a system properly. Then the next topic, that is, as you know, global warming potential. As per your syllabus, that is global warming potential. I discussed about the global warming potential in between the properties, second properties I discussed here. And then the next topic according to your syllabus is the refrigeration equipments, types and workings. So refrigeration equipment, that is the various refrigeration equipment, that is condenser, compressor, evaporators, and its working, which is already discussed in previously units in the classroom. So I don't think these topics are need to discuss more. If you anyone have any problem, she can any message and discuss with me on Google Classroom, or maybe personal problem. So that's all. So in this lecture, we discussed about the selection of the refrigerants, in which some important properties which decide the selection of the particular refrigerant for a particular application. So there are many requirements and then ideal refrigerant should meet. And all these requirements, as we have discussed in the lectures, but you find that in a practice there is a nothing like an ideal refrigerant. As we have discussed, we have not find there is any ideal refrigerant, so do not have any ideal refrigerant at all. And so always have a balance between the various requirements, and ultimately you do some kind of optimization and select a stable refrigerant. So there are some practical application and research is going on with refrigerants. So these are the about, so this, that's all about the topic of selection of refrigerants. Thank you so much.